Hey everybody, we're back with the Traxxas Rustler 4x4 project, and today we are going to work on the electronics. Here's what I have right here. Let's go over it really quick. We've got the telemetry expander, we've got the link wireless module, and of course the GPS telemetry module here. This is what I really want to install because I want to see how fast this thing goes. Right on the display that I will have on the transmitter using my phone. And then, as per your request, I am going to install a new steering servo. I have a Traxxas 400 steering servo here, high torque metal gear that's going to get swapped out. And then finally, we have the speed controller fan. Keep things cool. Why don't we head over to the workbench? Let's get started on swapping all these parts out. Where to start? I think we're going to start off by swapping out the steering servo. And to do that, I want to get the wire out of the receiver box first, just to make things a little bit easier as far as when I go to take the front end off. So what you're going to do here is you're going to take the top cap off that secures the wires, and then you're going to take the cap off that covers the receiver itself. So you're just going to need a 2.0 and a 2.5 millimeter hex driver to do that. With the receiver cover off, now we could remove the servo wire from the channel 1 port and then just slide it through the top of the case here. And now we're going to disassemble the front of the truck. It's actually just 5 screws to get the front clip off. The first screw you're going to remove is the steering arm screw, and then the 4 screws that hold the front clip on. With all the screws out of the front, now the front end should just come off. You just got to wiggle it a little bit and pull that off, and now we can access that servo there. And what I'm gonna do is just remove the 4 screws to get the servo out, and then we'll swap over the servo arm with the linkage to the new servo. Okay, all the hardware is out of the servo, and now you can just slide that right out. And now we gotta transfer over the servo arm and the servo linkage here. And I just want you guys to notice that the servo arm isn't straight up and down like a lot of cars are. This one is offset a little bit to the right when it's facing you. So that's the way it has to go on to the new servo. Now, before you drop in your new servo, you wanna make sure that everything is centered, starting with your radio. So take out your radio, make sure that the steering trim is centered. Then you're actually gonna go and power everything up. You're gonna plug this servo into the receiver and make sure it's centered. And that way, when you go and install everything, you're starting out with a nice neutral steering setting. It's gonna make your life a lot easier than having to tear everything apart to recenter everything. So with that said, I'm just gonna swap over the servo arm now and reinstall the servo in the truck. And with the steering arm swapped over, now just reinstall it back in the truck and assemble everything back together the same way you took it apart. I've got the front end back together, but I didn't put the receiver cover back on yet because we are putting in the telemetry expander, as I showed you guys before. And this is pretty easy to install as well. They give you all the hardware and stuff that you need to install this thing. It's located down here at the bottom of the box. And in there is a cable that you're going to need to plug into the receiver. So this is the communications cable right here. And that's just got to go into the communication port in the receiver. All right, so I've run that communication wire in through the top of the box and plugged it into the receiver. Now it only goes in one way. There's pins on one side, and you'll notice that there's a blank pin area on the other side. That's how you know to put it in properly. With that done, now we could go ahead and install the module in here, and it actually goes in both ways, but I'm gonna face it towards the back so the wires come out nice and short. And they actually give you a zip tie here so you can go bundle up all the wires nicely, but they also give you the 2 screws to secure that down to the front of the chassis. So I'm going to do that right now. After I bolted down the module, I also pulled off the covers because I have to put in that GPS module, which is really easy to do. It's basically this little square, and it pops in these pins right in the top of the module. Just like that, it's in. With the GPS module snapped into place, I put the first cover back on, and now I'm gonna go and plug in the communications cable. Just check with the instruction manual here. It shows you where to plug that cable in. And now before you go and put the cover back on, if you're gonna go and run this thing like out in the mud and water and stuff like that, they do give you some silicone grease, and you go and put it all over the foam pad here, and that helps seal everything up before you go and put the wire cover back on. So go ahead and do that. And then I'm gonna button up the rest of the receiver box and bundle up those wires so they're nice and neat, and put the cap back on with the screws. The modules are installed in the truck. Everything looks very cool. Now it's time to put in the link module into the transmitter, and this is another simple task. All you have to do is basically plug this module into the back of the radio. They even give you a extra little screw. I think there's already a screw in there. Yeah, there's already a screw in there. So they give you the tapping screw and the wrench to put it in. I'm just gonna use the screw that's already in there. So you just take this out of the back, pop this plastic cover out, take the new module, and just slide it in, and then replace the screw. Okay, now you have to pair the link module to the Traxxas link app. So I already have the Traxxas link app installed. Just going to open it up. And what you do is you go into the garage, you tap link wireless module, and it actually gives you a step-by-step on how to set it up. I'm gonna turn on my radio system here. I'm going to go and press the button until it's blinking. And now I just have to press here, number three. That was step number three. Oh, it's already connected. Look at that, the light's blue, it says it's connected. So that's ready to go. Now I just have to go and install the speed controller fan. And the speed controller fan is actually really easy to install. So I'm just gonna spin this around here. What you're going to do is there is a little red JST connector on the side of the speed controller. Just pull that out of the little harness. And then you could go and just snap the speed controller fan onto the heatsink here, just like that. And then you go ahead and plug in that little red JST connector to the fan. And so that wraps up the electronics portion of our Traxxas Rustler 4x4 project build. And I think this thing looks great overall. I can't wait to see how it performs, and I can't wait to see the speed on the telemetry readout. I think this is just going to be a lot of fun, but I'm not gonna show you it running just yet. That is going to be for the final video. So the next video, I'm gonna show you this thing in action. I'll show you the speech telemetry working as well. It's gonna be just a great action-packed video. So make sure you hit that subscribe button and the notifications bell so you don't miss it.